Hi everyone, welcome to my messy studio. My name is Mark, and I'm an artist and an art professor. And in this video, I'm going to share a valuable crosshatching lesson with you and tell you about my upcoming online workshops on crosshatching. Let's get started. One of the difficulties students have with crosshatching is covering large areas with value. Since the size of the area you can cover is limited by the length of the stroke, the only way to create a large even tone is to lay down a series of connecting patches of crosshatching. The problem with this is that it often ends up looking patchy and uneven. In this first sample, I'm putting down hatch marks in neat horizontal rows, trying to be as consistent in the distance between the lines as possible, and making sure that these rows run right up against each other, since if there's a gap between them or an overlap, it'll result in unevenness. Working this way results in bands running across my crosshatched value, which is less than ideal. This happens because the separations between the patches of hatching become more visible when the layers are aligned. One way to minimize such unevenness is to simply increase the length of the stroke. An easy way to do that is to grip the pen farther back, which creates a longer arc, resulting in longer strokes. Since the patches of hatch are larger, there are less border areas to create unevenness. However, while the results are better than the first sample, the second sample still suffers from the same problem, horizontal bands running across what should be a flat value. In this third sample, I'm going to resolve the issue of overlapping borders by staggering my layers of hatch. The first layer is still applied in a horizontal direction, and I'm still working in neat rows, trying my best, though not always succeeding, to make sure that the bands of hatching line up with no gaps or overlap. Then, instead of going over the next layer, I stagger it so the borders of the two layers do not line up. This results in a fairly even layer of value, perfectly satisfactory, but we can still see faint horizontal bands across the tone, and we can actually do better. In sample 4, the first layer is put down not in horizontal bands as before, but on a diagonal. I'm still trying to be careful not to leave gaps or overlaps between the bands, since that greatly affects the sense of evenness. Then the second layer is applied in bands running horizontally. Since these bands of hatch are applied in different directions, the chances of the borders aligning are diminished, resulting in a more even field of hatch. But believe it or not, we can still do better. In sample 5, I'm once again applying my hatching in a diagonal direction, but this time I'm staggering it so it doesn't create the subtle diagonal borders that were visible in the last sample. Then the second layer is also staggered so that it doesn't create a visible horizontal border. This way of working usually results in the most even flat values, and is what I tend to use when I need to cover a large area with a flat, even value. Creating even flat values is one of the more difficult aspects of crosshatching, in part because it's a tedious task that requires a steady hand and an equally steady focus. Just keep in mind that, like anything else, it can be mastered with patience and a bit of practice. I hope you found this mini lesson useful, and if you did, please consider taking my upcoming online workshop on crosshatching, titled The Fundamentals of Crosshatching, The 6 Basic Strokes. These 3-hour workshops will be full of lessons such as the one I gave you, and is designed for those of you just getting started with crosshatching, or for those that are looking to improve their crosshatching techniques. Please visit my website for more information, and if you know anyone that might be interested, please let them know. These workshops are doing well, but there are still plenty of spaces available, and I need your help getting the word out. Thanks so much for watching, and hope to see you back in my messy studio soon, or better yet, in one of my upcoming workshops. Bye-bye.